Very good evening, dear participants. Very happy to be connecting with all of you to discuss and answer all the questions that all of us have about data science. I'm sure this is some word that all of us have been hearing for a while now, definitely, if not longer period. And we will answer all of your questions. We are also very much eagerly waiting to get deeper into this thought process and understand more. Break the ice and become more curious about this data science. And so far, we have already received about 100 questions, and we will kind of a lot of similar type of questions. So we've kind of structured them, and starting from the first basic question of what is data science, and we will start going on and talking about, you know, how as young professionals or as freshers we can start a career, or how as students not from computer science IT but get into a career in data science. If you are already working, even then, how do we make a career switch, get into data science? So these are all, I think, the common set of questions that we've got. We will start talking about it. And of course, how do we even start, right? That's one of the most important questions. So these are, I think, the broad set of questions that we will start exploring. Before we start interacting, I will tell you the format in which we will conduct this session. So let me just share my screen once. So I hope the screen is visible now. So this is the fourth episode on this sort of an Ask Me Anything series that we have started on data science. Again, I'm happy that there are so many people who are interested, and this is upcoming profession, more highly in demand. So all of us are very curious to know more about it. So let's get into that. Firstly, the format of how this interaction is going to be. All of you have the option of posting your thoughts on the Zoom chat. So please utilize that option, and you can express your ideas, friends, everything on that chat. Even if you want to speak on microphone, you have to post on the chat asking the panelists to give you that option to speak on the microphone. If you just raise your hand, it will be difficult for us to recognize and control it that way. So you'll have to post on the chat saying you would like to speak on the microphone and ask your question. But when you are asking your question, please make sure that there is no background noise at all. And as soon as you are done speaking, you'll have to mute yourself once again so that it is comfortable for all. One very, very important request to all of you is to pay proper attention to all the questions and all the answers. It is very much possible that, you know, the question that you have on your mind, somebody else can ask, or that question could have an overlap. And the answers also could add up to giving you the answer to the kind of thoughts or questions that you have on your mind. So it's very important that you pay proper attention to the entire interaction. More important thing is, please do wait for your turn. All of you will get the chance to ask a question, and all of your questions will be answered for sure. But please be patient. Please wait until your turn. We will try and answer every question, but we will try and follow a sequence as well so that there is some structure to this. Okay, so let me show what are some of the most popular questions that we have got in while registration. All these questions are structured into this sort of a categorization. First is the most fundamental question of what is data science after all, and how is it related to AI or big data or deep learning, all those things. Second is, what are the major applications of data science in the real world? I mean, is there really a scope for a career in data science? I think that is, second and third question are more or less overlapping, but I think that's one major area of interest. Then we will talk about how as young professionals, how as freshers, you can start a career in data science right from as soon as you graduate? I think that is, again, a very, very interesting question. We will answer that. We will spend a lot of time on that. So don't worry, we will come to that. And of course, how can you even start? Right? If you, can you start? And if yes, how can you start? That's the right, that's the question that we will be focusing on today. How as students from non-computer science IT also can get into the career of data science? I think that is one important question. On the panel, we have somebody who has done it already, so we can hear directly from her. Then if you've got any other technical questions, you know, any particular concept, if you're already familiar with data science, that is one area. But if you have already done it, I would request you to be a little bit patient until we get to that part, or you know, some of your questions may be answered in the first couple of questions itself. So because there is some bit of an overlap there as well. And if you want to know more, finally, the last question is that we do have a program on data science. It's called Certified Data Science Engineering Program. The next cohort is starting soon. So we will talk a little bit about that, and we can tell you how you can also apply and take it up. So that's the format in, and the structure in which we will have this sort of an interaction. Please feel absolutely free. Don't think of it like a typical classroom where you have to keep quiet and just listen to us. Feel free and express your thoughts and comments and questions. We will try and answer each one of them, but please be patient and pay attention to all other interaction as well. So that's what we request from you. So let me also welcome the panelists and guests that we have here today. I have Ashokan Pichai, who is our Chief Learning Officer at Talent Sprint, and he's seen as a legendary person in programming altogether. So we're very happy that he has taken out his time for us and to interact with us. Then we have Dr. Habib and Surabhi, who are also experts in data science. And they are the ones who have designed this whole program for us, and they can answer all your questions. So let's get started, and let's extract all that information that's on their minds, and let's get their wisdom for us. Okay. So the floor is open to questions, and we'll start with the first question itself. I would request, I think Dr. Habib to answer the first question, and like from the beginning, let us know what is data science first, after all, and how is it related? If you have any slides, I can stop the screen share and you can also put it up.
Yeah, good afternoon, everyone. Do you think I'm audible now?
Yes, Habib. And I'm going to turn off
my stop sharing the screen so I can just share my screen.
Sure, I'm going to do that. Yeah, screen is yours.
Yeah. Okay, so if you see here, so before going for a data science, actually, what is a data science? Data science is nothing but it is going to start with the aim of solving a problem, actually. So it is going to collect the data through advanced in mathematics and statistics that show how the problem we are going to solve using and devices and the right solution for them. Okay, so this is what exactly the data science. So we can say that the classic definition of data science, we can say that combination of statistics and something like a software engineering and domain expertise. So as I said, like first we begin with the aim of solving a problem first. For that, we are going to collect the data through some mathematics and statistical things. And then we show how we are going to start this problem or how do you going to give the solution for this problem. So here you see some different kinds of terminology. So something like what is artificial intelligence, machine learning, then deep learning, then combination of big data. And then we are going to see the term called as data science here. Okay, so now in the data science, if you want to know about the data science. So before going for the data science, you must know what is about like in the chart something. Okay, so basic knowledge of, you must have mathematics, basic knowledge of statistical inference, what we call. And we do some data visualization, and we must have something like the domain expert knowledge you must have for the data science. As you know, what is artificial intelligence? Artificial is nothing but it uses computer algorithm to predict future events, what we call. Now, one of the subfield of artificial intelligence is nothing but a machine learning, and then we are going to have subfield of AI is something like a deep learning, and the data science is going to deal with huge amount of the data. So that is what we call as a big data. So the simple definition goes something like this. So first we must have some problem solution. First aim is we think of something like we need to solve any problem. So the things are like you must have a domain knowledge and some mathematical knowledge, and then you must have a software engineering. There we are going to have some combination of machine learning. So this combination completely what we call as data science. Hope the answer okay, Ritwik.
Yes, sir. Thanks a lot.
You see this slide. So this slide will give you the complete picture over here. Something what we are going to do, like the combination of statistics and machine learning and data analysis tools. These complete three things we call it as data science. And this will give you the complete depict of what exactly the data science is.
Clear? Superb. This is a very interesting slide for us, and it very well depicts. Surabhi, would you also like to add something to this?
Yes, sure. Can I share my screen?
Yes.
Yes. So, hello everyone, and welcome to this data science session. And I am Surabhi. So on similar lines to what Dr. Habib just mentioned, I would like to tell you that how these fields have evolved. So from 1950s to 2000, you can see how the evolution has happened in these fields. And basically data science, if you see here, it is just, it can also be expressed as something that we use to understand trends and to remodel systems, okay? So that is what data science and statistics is, and it existence-wise, it was, it predates artificial intelligence, of course. But after that, as we go through the years, we see that artificial intelligence makes an entry, and basically it is just simulating intelligent human behavior in machines. So that is what the field of artificial intelligence is. And then a major approach in AI, in artificial intelligence, that gained a lot of thrust because of its predictive power is machine learning. And machine learning is basically when a system learns through examples or through data, okay? And it's not explicitly programmed, but the machine learning algorithms are such that the system learns from the data. So this is very useful in predictions, decision making, etc. And finally, something that came about in the past decade, or which gained a lot of importance in the past few years, is deep learning. And deep learning is based on neural networks, which is one of the subsets of a machine learning approach. So deep learning is a branch of machine learning, and it can deal with complex data sets. And it has recently gained importance because large data sets are now available. The computational power has now increased. So because of reasons, it has now started. And also it is very useful in image recognition, speech recognition. A lot of these tasks are performed with very high accuracy by deep learning. So yeah, that's what from my side.
Well, thanks a lot, Surabhi. I think this is very, very insightful. When the few examples that you talked about of the image recognition, speech recognition and all are actually the some of the most common applications which all of us are using on a day-to-day basis.
And, that's right.
And definitely, I think such kind of applications can be found almost in every sector, every industry. So I think we'll get into the next question directly, which is about that itself. about what is what are some of these major applications of data science in the real world. And I would like Ashokan sir to answer this question, give us some insights into some of these most happening applications of data science.
Hello everybody, this is actually almost like asking what, where can I use computers, what are the major applications of computers. If you compare with the early days of computers, today there are a few differences. The problems we want to solve have become more complex. There is a huge amount of data available. For example, the number of web pages is in the billions. If any website, if you run, if 1,000 visitors come every day, each person leaves behind 10, 20, 30 log entries because the pages they visit, everything. So at the end of a month, you have millions of lines of data. So effectively, data science is useful wherever there is large volumes of data. When we say large, we are typically talking of millions of pieces of data. And what we want to do is, we want to discover patterns and behaviors which is not obvious. In a traditional program, we know what we want the system to do. We will say, if this happens, do that. If that happens, do this. If this happens, tell the user you have made a mistake. If this happens, tell the user, thank you very much, here. But instead, we would like to discover what is happening. To give a very simple example, if you have a website and you are logging whoever comes at what time and you analyze it over months and you find, okay, this is happening. A large number of people are visiting our website between 12:30 and 1:30 or 12:30 and 2:30. Then you can discover, oh, a lot of people during lunch break in their offices are accessing their computers and our website. So this sort of insight you can't be programming for because you don't know it is there till you actually look at the data, analyze it, then you figure out what is happening. That is why it is data science. You form a hypothesis, you test the hypothesis, you form a theory, and then build other experiments to validate it. Finally, use it to say, okay, if people are coming at lunchtime, what is that is likely to be? They would like to have quick answers because they have to go back to their work. They are not likely to be taking too much time to discover many things. Like that, you can form hypothesis and test it out. So to summarize, data science application is wherever there is data. You are not going to get separate data science companies, separate data science applications. Every organization which deals with large amount of business, whatever be the nature of business, is sitting on a large amount of data. All these companies are using data science to varying degrees. They may use an off-the-shelf software and use it, or they may roll their own detailed analytics. But machine learning, artificial intelligence, data science, whatever name you give to the particular perspective, every single organization today is doing some amount of it. In fact, NASSCOM has estimated 75% of all projects have some components of AI/ML data science. Okay. Anyway, I hope that was a good starting point. In case we don't catch up with you all again, all the very best in your career. Include, let's hope there will be a lot of data science in your career.
Thank you very much, Ashokan. I think that was very, very exciting way of understanding data science. In fact, while you were talking about it, I was visualizing if I were a data scientist or somebody who's in this profession, I would, what sort of activities I would do. And that's very, sounds very, very, very exciting. And definitely the kind of insights that one can generate with data today are a lot more, and that's a very meaningful profession to pursue. Yes, I think the next question, so there's one question on the chat as well. If you're a degree student from statistics background, can you learn data science and how will be the future for degree students? Well, we'll answer that question, and which is related to the questions that are lined up. But to put so, I think in brief, I think you have an advantage that you are already studying statistics. People who are doing a traditional engineering degree program also are looking for additional certification in data science. And you also can match up to some mixed curriculum that probably will fit you, and will can give you that boost for the starting the career. Definitely, I think having statistics background is a great advantage for you. So yes, I think the next question also is something that we have already covered in our discussion so far, that when we mentioned virtually almost every industry, every business is now going to have at least 75% of AI, ML, and data science involved in it. So it's the career is opportunities are just ever expanding in this. And let us also just show some information to you that's already available in our program. We have also listed down some of our observations there. I'll be sharing that screen now. Yeah. So here's our program page, and you can see that some of the statistics here that, you know, average salaries for data engineers range from 10 to 15 lakh rupees per annum. This is, again, let me tell you, it's including for freshers, if you've got the right skills. And across the globe, there will be an increase in job openings of up to, I think 27 lakhs, 20,000 data scientists in 2020. This is a report from IBM. And you can also see the banking, energy, healthcare, e-commerce, media, retail, all industries are seeking data engineers. And so I think these are just some of the statistics. You can go deeper and understand what are these roles, some of the popular key phrases that are mentioned, data scientist, business intelligence developer, data analyst. Habib, would you like to throw some insight into what these roles mean? Or
yeah, before that, Ritvik, let me share one screen.
Sure.
So, okay. Okay, if you see the presentation, so most of the students are asking about like what is the career options in data science, why people are moving towards the data science. So there is a 5 reasons to build a career in data science. We can say data is fuel for the business now. So what is mean by data is fuel? What do you mean by data is fuel? So now an example, I'll just show you some of the statistics. So from that you can understand. Actually now we say that data contains 3 V's, that is velocity, volume, and variety, something like this. So this is a huge explosion of the data now coming on. If you take an example of 2019, every minute of the data, it is coming from variety of sources, like, you know, the Twitter, Tumblr, e-commerce, Instagram, like if you see in every minute, how much of data, the downloads from the stores, apps, how they are coming, text is coming and going, how the emails are sending. If you see the huge amount of data is coming, okay. Now we can think of the data as something like a new oil to the industry. So data science is in demand skills. Now, if you see here, the graph hiring at fresher in the mid-level to pickups. So now if you see here, the graph from 2016 to 2019. So less than 1 year, 1 to 2 years, 2 to 5 years, 7 to 10 years, more than 15 years, how the growing up. Okay, from this graph, you can easily understand the demand of the freshers to the senior people. Okay. So now this is one of the slide where you can easily understand like industry needs how many people in data science professionals. Like it needs around 140K data science they need it. Now the most of the people they say that we don't have like, you know, we don't have an experience. How can we get into the market? Or suppose say that we are in different domain now. How can we jump into this domain? And everybody say that I want to become a data scientist or data science engineer, something like that. It's not like that. The thing is, once you do something like a data science course, you have to see that what is the job description. So where you are going to fit into, that's it. So you cannot say that there is no job role, like particularly we cannot say like this is the job role, something like that. So whenever you're applying, the main thing is you have to see what is the job description. So according to the job description, you can apply and you can get a chance of getting into the market. Okay. So you can build your data science expertise, something like this. So this is the, like if anybody having any field, you are from mathematics background or you're from computer science background, engineering, social sciences, commerce, or business administration, physical sciences, because these are the questions coming from most of the participants saying that I'm having mathematical background. Can I get into the market with data science or not? Computer science background, engineering background, no problem anyway. Because even computer science BTech first year, we study some basics of mathematics and statistics, right? So engineering people, we study social background, like social at level of 10th class, we studied. Commerce people, they study statistics. Business administration, BBA, they study. So most of the people, they study, okay? So this is not a big deal. So any programming knowledge, Python is a language such a way that everybody who is having little bit of logical thinking, they can easily get into that language. So another one, a wide range of opportunities awaiting for your expertise. Next, this is the one which you can see here. So how the graph, if you see here, the data science, already we have seen the data science is a multidisciplinary disciplinary. So the people having suppose domain knowledge also they can enter into it. Okay. So these are the data science job roles: data creator, data scientist, data manager, data librarian, something like this. These are some of the job roles. Okay, Ritvik.
Thanks a lot, Habib. I think we have a couple of questions we should answer now.
Yes.
So Abhi Singh is asking if we can give some advice on some real-time application of data science. So I think he wants to go deeper into the subject and probably take up one project and do something interesting. Before we answer, I think one request for all the participants, please just turn off your camera. That will accommodate the bandwidth and make it comfortable for all. Either any of the panelists can answer this question.
Okay, Abhi Singh, I will give you something which is not available on internet.
Yes.
Okay, now real-time problem. Let us take some real-time problem. I'll explain you something like this. Now, let us take something, an example. You know what we call in medical field, we call it as data vigilance. So there is a people who did the pharmacovigilance, we call it, who did an M-pharmacy or who did something like a PhD in pharmacovigilance, we call it, these people. The role of these people is when any drug is released, every drug is having some combination. It doesn't have only one drug. Suppose if you take any drug, when you see the drug is having some combination of drugs, which is leading for destroying of some bacteria, something like that. When the drug is released in the market, the drug is having some impact on the patients. So there is a role called as pharmacovigilant. These people, what they will do, they will do the research on what is the impact of this drug on the various kinds of the people who is having previously some diseases like heart disease is there. Some people, they are having stomach pain and something like that. Okay. So now these people are collecting the data with something like millions of people or something. They cannot collect all huge amount of the data. So collecting this huge amount of the data take a lot of time. And after that, they will try to make something analysis on that, which is the drug making more impact. So coming to the end of the statement saying that, okay, this is the drug causing. So it may take something 10 years of span coming saying that, okay, this is the drug where it's making an impact. Maybe this is the reason it is for cancer, something like that. So they can, after submitting the results, the World Health Organization, WHO, saying that, okay, please ban this drug. So what I can do now, this is my problem statement now. So now I'll take that problem statement. I'll take the huge amount of the data, not only from my country, because the drug is manufactured in various countries. So I'm going to collect all the information of all the patients from different countries. Now, if you take an example of this pandemic itself, if you fare fever or something, some medicine also which is released, we can take the drug information of all the countries, and then we can prepare the analysis of this drug and we can submit to the WHO. So can we proceed this in this much of time span? So how can we do this? This can be done using a data science job is possible. So collecting the data by using some mathematical, applying some mathematical formulas, then giving to machine learning algorithm, then coming to some, okay, solution, this is what we needed. So this is possible. Hope the answer, Abhi.
Yes, Abhi, I think that was great.
Yes. So Abhi, and I would also like to add, so real time, maybe you mean that any source of data that is constantly changing and getting updated. So I think you could also use data online from databases that has weather reports or stock quotes or tweets, and apply data science techniques to derive insights from those.
But this is now emerging problem. Most of the people from pharmaco industry, they're approaching for the data scientists for this problem to get the market to release the drugs for this pandemic, for the COVID. Everybody approaching. So for the most of the companies working on this now. So this is a real-time solved problem now. It's emerging. So this is a simple solution. Like you can take this problem and even you can take the data and you can do it. So data is open from every country. You can just take the data. Even you take any simple drug also you can do it.
That is right. COVID based data is continuously emerging and that would be the most beneficial to derive insights from.
Okay, so I think we'll move to the next set of questions. So Abhi, if you want to know more, go much deeper, you can please post your questions, but please try and be specific so that we can also answer. So some of the questions that have come up are what, as a fresher, how can you start a career or what are the skills that are needed? And if you're not from a computer science IT background, I think one question was, you're from an electronics background, currently doing masters in BLSI. So how can we still get into data science field or this questions like this? So what we can do, I think, is we will show what program that we have come up with. This is a program that is open for all the talented people who are, who can apply getting on getting selected can start taking the course. But what's important to notice that if you are from a computer science background, even then you can take it up. Even if you're not from a computer science background, you can take it up. If you are a fresher, you can take it up. If you are an undergraduate student, second year, third year, you can still take it up. If you are doing your master's or if you're already doing a job, you can still take it up. It's a very well-structured program. I think we'll spend some time looking at the curriculum. It also tells you what are these prerequisite skills that you need and how you can build and how you can start getting the right set of skills for you to become a data science professional. Of course, that program also comes with placement assistance, so it can help you with, give you that head start of starting a career right after the program. So before that, I think I would like to ask Surabhi to just briefly tell us your story, that how you've got into this data science profession, though you're not from computer science IT background.
Yes, surely. One of the main questions that we often encounter is whether being from a different field, will we be able to learn data science and contribute? So let me tell you my story. I am a PhD in biology, actually, and I have worked as a scientist in the biotech area for many years. And towards the in the last few years, I was getting a lot of data from hospitals as part of the research that we were doing. And what I understood is that it does have a lot of information in it from which if we use the right tools, we'll be able to gather a lot of insights from it. And I started getting interested in it and exploring as to what I could do to gain the knowledge on this. And given that data science uses statistics, math, programming, from all of these things, the only part that I knew was some math that I had done in during my school, so up to class 12. And programming, I did not have knowledge of, and also statistics I was using a bit. Biostatistics, but that would be my profile at that time. But then got interested, I decided to take the AIML course offered by IIIT Hyderabad. When I joined, I joined with a lot of apprehension as to how I would be able to do it. But a little bit of preparation before the course and the teaching and the mentorship that was there,
it helped me to go through the course, and it opened my eyes to a lot of new things that we could actually apply to our field. So that was really exciting for me, and I am still learning, and that put me in the process of learning further and trying to apply to my field. So the only message from my story I would like to tell all of you who are also apprehensive is that it is achievable, and you just have to, sometimes we just perceive things as obstacles, but actually they might not be. So you have to get past that, and the thing is that although it requires coding, the Python language is such that you will be able to learn it and apply as per your requirements. So there is a lot that can be achieved, and the demand is very high. So I'm sure that people from different fields have to come in now, and the interdisciplinary activity where someone knows something else and now is doing data science, that will help in a lot. It will progress things a lot. So yeah, that's what I would like to say.
Thanks a lot, Surabhi. So I think the most important question that most of the participants have is that how to start, right? How to even where to start after all, right? So I think we'll and try and answer that question. We'll start talking about that with looking at the program structure that we have developed itself. I hope the screen is visible. We can put up the content that we have developed, so that can be a basis on which you can explain. So here's the curriculum. I would like Habib to just take us through, you know, how the basic foundation skills and the deep tech expertise that can add up and build the skills that are required.
Ritvik, hello, am I audible?
Yes, Habib.
So everybody have a question saying that how do we start up, like the basic thing. So we have built a data science framework in such a way that first we have a basic foundation. So there we are going to give you the complete Python. So then we are going to have data munging and visualization. And then we are going to have deep tech, like, you know, the expertise, like what is a big data, what is Hadoop, and what is meant by Spark. And then we have some projects. So here, in the programming foundation, we are going to take into the complete Python. And whereas in analytical methods, we are going to take about like how do you do the data munging and visualization. And then we are going to discuss about the mathematical foundation, the complete statistics, inferential statistics, and differential statistics. And then we are going to have overview of AML. So as I have shown you in the beginning of the slide deck, it is a data science is the combination of the statistics and ML and the visualization. So all these things will be covered in this foundation complete course. So no need to worry about how the course will go on. So according to that, we have built the course, which is going to lead. So according to this, any job description, you can get into the market. Once you finish this course, directly you can enter into the market, and you can see you can fulfill the job requirements easily. Okay.
Thanks a lot, Habib. So Ashokan sir, would you also like to elaborate on this, like how and why it is so important to build on these foundational skills first, and the right set of expertise, the combination that we have come up with, maybe that will help students understand the skill sets better?
See, the data science is about solving business problems. Be it customers are coming, they are seeing these pages, but they are not buying. Customers are buying only one item. Customers are not buying items which are in discount. Like this, you start with a business problem and then you analyze it and then arrive at a particular approach based on what the data is telling you. Or it could be even a software engineering problem. We have a software system built with many microservices and some of them are failing more often than not. So we would like to predict when it is likely to fail, or we would like to predict what time my server is likely to be overloaded. Like that, all problems start with a business issue. So what you need to do is to have the ability to abstract out the problem. That is the most critical skill. Whatever you have studied, doesn't matter. One of the best programmers I know, and he became a delivery manager in a major company and is in charge of analytics and all that. His basic degree was in nutrition and dietetics. But he is one of the best system designers I know. He could look at a large problem, break it down nicely into pieces, and then say, these pieces have to be solved like this. So that is exactly the biggest skill you'll have to develop. Given a particular situation, how do I throw away unnecessary detail, abstract the essence, and then pull out, okay, how do I validate this? How do I figure out what is happening? The problem formulation and abstraction skills are the biggest need. And that is not something only a computer science student or only a BCom student or only an MBA student has. Everybody can and should develop it. Should not be looking for formulas and standard problems. Instead, you should look at how do I develop this skill by practice, of course, and practice solving problems. Then automatically you will be able to apply it to different situations. And that is how you build on your skills. You need coding skills. You need basic mathematics skills. On top of that, you build these abstraction and problem solving skills. You will be a very valuable resource.
Thank you very much, Shukan. So for all those people who are asking this question of how can I start, how to even start, so I think this is one such program that we have come up with. You can visit our webpage. It's on the screen currently, what I'm showing. You can download this entire syllabus and go through it. And you can actually apply and talk to us also, so that we can explain you in person as to where you currently stand. And if you're ready for taking this course and if you should take it up, by when will you be ready? So I think we have discussed, this is one of the most important questions, and we have talked about the starting point. Repeatedly, I think we are emphasizing that you need not be belonging to a specific discipline of learning per se, whether you are an engineering student or a degree student, whether you're doing computer science or civil engineering, it doesn't matter. Think of skill sets, and like Ashokan sir said, mathematical foundations, programming foundations, and the ability to abstract a problem. And so I think these are the things which with which we have to try and analyze ourselves, whether we are ready or not. And we have a program that is designed for you to build these skills and in a time-bound manner. And this is a program that comes with a placement assistance so that you can have a head start in a data science career directly. So I think let's look at some more new questions that have been coming up. Rajshekhar Reddy is asking, is it tough to get a job as for a fresher in data science? Once again, I would like to ask Ashokan sir to respond to this. How tough or easy is it for a fresher to crack a job directly in data science?
See the typed question. Can you repeat it?
Is it tough to get a job for a fresher in data science?
Actually, everybody is hiring people with fresher hiring is less compared to, say, 2-3 years back. That is a given. And the new freshers are being hired only if they have something more than basic coding skills available. So let me put it this way. your chances of getting hired as a fresh data science person are higher than getting hired as a normal programmer, unless, of course, this is assuming your college, if you are in a college and your college placement is there, then yes, your college is going to get you something. But if there you have not managed it, then if you have these strong skills I talked about, your chances are much better than getting into basic coding jobs, because the basic coding jobs are reducing a lot. People need higher order skills for doing the same job. Basic jobs have been automated. So, for example, till 3 years back, every company had hundreds of testers. Now they don't, because those jobs have been automated using machine learning, data science, and AI. So, like that, as a fresher, the number of fresher jobs definitely has come down. And the minimum skill required has definitely gone up. So, yes, it is tough to get a job as a fresher. But if you have qualified yourself in a in-demand skill, not just going through a course is going to be enough. You have to actually develop your skill in all the areas I talked about. Yes, you stand a much better chance of landing a job. Of course, we can never give a guarantee about anything, but yes, you stand a much better chance with these skills than without these skills.
Thank you very much, Ashokan. I think I would like to just add one point here, saying that, you know, it is definitely tough to get a job if you are not having these advanced skills, right? With the same set of skill sets which were being imparted 10, 15 years back, I don't think the demand in the industry is the same that it was there before. So what you're getting in college may not be enough. You definitely have to go a step beyond. You have to figure out what is your interest area. If data science is one, then you must build the skills, and that will give you not just a chance of getting a job, but in fact, a great start for your career and a faster growth as well. So some more questions have come. I think this is about the program, whether what is the fee, cost, and all. It's on this page that that's currently on display. You can find it. I will also just put it up. We will talk about the program a little bit later, and we'll try and answer some more questions that are more relevant for data science and building the career first. I think some questions again have come up, whether machine learning is a subset of data science. What's the difference? I think these are topics which we have answered or discussed right at the beginning of the session. I'm not sure if you've joined on time or not, but we will not be able to bring it up again. If there are any other questions about whether you can start a career in data science or not, what are the skill sets required or not, if such kind of questions are there, we can take some more. Otherwise, we'll talk more about the program that we have. Okay, so Anudita Kishri has messaged saying you have experience with machine learning and now you're diving into DL, but I'm finding it difficult to land a job. What should I do next? So Surabhi, would you like to try and answer to this question?
Yes, Anudita. So you already have some experience in ML, and you are now currently into deep learning. And so it depends what is your, are you doing it on your own, or are you being mentored on it? Are you taking a course? And is that, as Ashokan sir said, that if you learn to the extent and apply to the extent that is above the basic, like you can, so then you stand ahead in the competition. And otherwise, I would also like to suggest that there are internships in data science available, and these help to advance the career of freshers. So any such opportunities should be availed. And so yeah, that would be my advice. And maybe Habib or Ashokan may add to it. I don't know.
Yeah, I think internships are a great suggestion, Surabhi. I think definitely it's not necessarily that, you know, we crack the dream job in the first go itself. Each of these experiences will add up. And meanwhile, if you can parallelly build more skill sets and do the right kind of projects and build that portfolio for yourself, then again, that can get you a greater chance of landing the right job.
Yes, definitely. Yeah.
So again, some more questions have come up asking what are the skill sets. So let me again just reemphasize that our program is a great example of how you can start a career building the right set of skill sets. It is on this page. You can download the full syllabus and take a look at it. It talks about the kind of knowledge plus activities or the technology skills that you will need for you know, getting that breakthrough in a data science profession. Internships, like just now we discussed, that's again a great opportunity for you to actually test out your skills and understand even what is the functionality of somebody in a data science profession. And that gives you a greatest chance of converting that internship into a full-time employment. So I think now we can talk a little bit more about our program. Because I think a lot of people are asking what are the fees and what is the timeline and all those things. Are there any other questions that we should answer before we move to that? Okay, I think a couple of questions have come. I think Taimina, your question was that you're from pharma background, can you join data science? We have kind of answered that. Surabhi is one person who has had a similar journey, moving from pharma or molecular biology kind of background to data science now. So it is definitely possible. If yes, then how? The question for all the people asking how you can start a data science profession is by building the right set of skill sets. Please take a look at the program that we have. It tells you what are these skill sets. We have structured it in a right curriculum format for you. We have a program that we can deliver while you have your regular coursework or day job while you're still doing it. So let me just put that up on the slide and showcase to you how the program format also works. It's an instructor-led online training, and the lectures are happening on weekends. On top of that, there will be a weekly doubt clearing session also. So this is how can you start? The question is this: you choose the right kind of program for you that gives you the skills right from foundations where you start from and goes into all the advanced levels, and where you get a chance to do a project work which you can showcase to the industry. And all this is something that you can do while you continue to do what you're actually doing, like whether if you're a student continuing your academic program, if you are a working professional continuing your regular day job. You can do this program while in parallel also, and you can still gain the skill sets that are required to become a data science professional. So that's what it is, and you should visit this page because we will have more details, some testimonials from the previous participants. The fee is here. Fee is also mentioned right at the beginning itself, because with the Independence Day, we have come up with an offer that is offering this program at a reduced price. Please remember that this is a program that comes with placement support also, right? So getting the right kind of projects, internships, how do you even build a profile that, once you have acquired these skills, you have to showcase it to the world. You can't continue to, chase recruiters saying, I'm applying, not getting. You have to kind of attract recruiters. So for that to happen, you should have a proper digital profile where recruiters who are looking for people like you with the right kind of skills and ambitions, they can find you and they can give you the right kind of opportunity to you. And we will also, on top of this, we're having a lot of mock interview preparation, the kind of preparation that requires in a data science profession is different. We can support you with that. And on top of that, you will have a lot of mentorship from industry professionals itself, which is huge. And as you can see, the participants of this program, we have a target CTC of which is more than 5 lakhs, even for a fresher, right? So, but only thing is, this is not a program that is open to all. Not everybody and anybody can apply and take part. You have to go through a selection process because this is a limited intake program. So for that, you'll have to apply, you have to write your statement of purpose. And once this is done, then our selection team will connect with you. They will ask you some questions, but then figure out, you may have to give another round of tests. Then if once you get selected, then of course you can enroll. It is listed again here that the next batch is starting August 29th, right? So you can immediately apply. You think, take a moment to give a nice statement of purpose. Why do you even want to get into data science? Of course, all the reasons are all in this page itself, that it's a very rewarding profession and it's highly in demand, but you have to go deeper and say, you know, you are capable of doing well in this. So, you can also view our placement brochure about how people and students or participants of our programs have successfully got placed in some of the top companies, getting great packages and all. And there are, of course, a lot more details with FAQs and everything where you will understand a lot more of your questions being answered here. So I think these are the most important things. One more thing I think you should know is that this program is delivered on our platform, which is not like typically this Zoom interaction that we're having. This has got a lot more features where you can have, you know, group activities done. The video lectures that will be available for you will have, you know, AI powered indexes, which means you can search within the concepts and search the concept within the video, and you can have a very great experience. And of course, the peer interaction is also going to be a key factor, because the people you learn this profession with are going to be extremely important. The way you move with people who are aspiring to get into high-end jobs, people who want to understand data science at a deeper level, the more conversations you have with such kind of people, the more you also grow into it. So I think that's all some of the things that you can get out of a program like this. Please do visit this webpage. It is talentsprint.com /data-science.dpl. And you can apply in this box here. And once you get selected, then you can enroll. Also, please note that this offer is still there. The actual fee is 1,28,000 or something. But now, thanks to this Independence Day offer and all, you are going to get it. And don't even worry about the payment, because you've got 24 months, which is 2 full years of 0% EMI options available for this. Right, so you have multiple plans. Don't even think it's a reduced price for you. On top of that, you have got all these flexible payment options. So you can comfortably enroll and you can start getting into a data science profession right here. So let me take a look at some of the questions now. Once again, the course is online, like it's a live in online interaction. It is not like a recorded video alone. So it's going to be the kind of experience you would get in a physical classroom, but online. So you can take it up from wherever you are. You don't have to travel, and it's not recommended in this current pandemic situation also. How does your program differ from others? Can I know what percentage of your previous? So let me tell you, this is a program that comes with placement assistance, which means that we are going to give you a lot of opportunities for placement. But what matters is how you perform in the interview, right? We all can give guarantee opportunities, job interviews, but not a job offer. Job offer is something that you have to prove in the interview. And these people are coming to interview you because you have got this certification already. The certification shows to the world that you have got these skills. But what goes on in the interview is more than the technical skills alone, right? Your aspirations, ambitions, your people skills, all those things also are very much necessary. I think those are things that which you have to build in parallel, your managerial skills and your communication skills. While we can help you with a lot of digital profile building and other activities like that, those are things that you should already have. So that is one thing about, you know, what percentage of PBS. We are aiming for 100%, but the outcome is dependent on the participant also. After enrolling into the program, if you don't attend the lectures, then you know who can get you the job. So that's how it works. And now let me tell you really how our program differs from other programs. I don't know about every other program, but let me give you the most common examples. What is like the Coursera or all other platforms like that? Whatever programs which are publicly available, it is expected that you already learn or already you are, you know, getting those skill sets readily. This is a program which has a limited intake, which has peer learning, and which is, when I say limited intake and peer learning, this is a peer group that is highly aspirational, ambitious, talented, and these are people who will ultimately become data science professionals. So you have a network of people like this, right? And of course, you have interacted with some of the faculty members directly here. These are people who are great experts in data science and AI, machine learning, and all the upcoming technologies. So live interaction plus the kind of platform that we have, I think that's the biggest differentiator. So I think Charchit is asking, after data science course, can you apply and get placed in any government sector? So let me tell you, Digital India is, you know, one major government initiative that has come up. There are a lot of government organizations which run like a private organization nowadays, and they do take in lateral entries also, and they are looking for skill sets like this. So MyGov is one such kind of a company where you can keep posting jobs, and you can definitely apply there. Of course, the placement support, we are not sure if we have supporting directly for them to come and interview. They have a different process, but they are welcoming people with data science skills in a lateral entry. So you don't have to go through the same standard testing, but they have direct applications as well. Even state governments have, and even central governments have. A lot of opportunities coming up on that front, and it's growing. So any other question? I think if not, we are on scale as per the schedule. The 5:30 to 6:30 is what we have this session. We are at 6:30. If there are no further questions, we can end it. I hope we answered almost all the questions. If not, please do write to us. We will try and revert back to you on email. Otherwise, you can also let all your friends who are also thinking of a data science profession to check out our program page, reach out to us. And we will definitely guide you through whether it's the right thing for you, right time for you, and how at all you can start it. Duration, of course, like it's on this page again, 16 weeks. It's starting from August 29th. And I think it's a short period enough for you to build a great range of skills in data science, and it works well. Okay, I think on that note, seeing no further questions, we can end this. One final thing I would like to just inform all the attendees here is that you can follow our Instagram page, because we keep posting a lot of interesting insights on data science. We actually started an Instagram series called Data Se Dosti, and where we were posting, you know, how data science is used in sports and medicine, and transport, and all these things, and you can, I think that's something that will interest you as well. I'd recommend you follow our Instagram handle. It's talentsprint_edu. Great, on that note, thank you all for once again for joining this another episode of Ask Me Anything series, and very, very thanks to our panelists once again, Ashokan sir, Habib, and Surabhi, for taking out your time and explaining all the participants about all the questions that they have. And on that note, I would like to say have a very good evening and have a. So thanks once again. I think on that note, we can end this session. A very good evening to all of you and have a great day.